should be played at high volume, preferably in a residential area.
All right, 1 2 1 2. Welcome back to another episode of the Power Hour, August 30th, 2023. Sometimes I forget what year it is. I know this week's show's all out of sync and out of whack. Usually we start at 9:30. Too many things going on. I have to wake up, go to the Bronx. I have to get a plumber in here to fix the shit, life shit. Today's show is dedicated to Mac J. He's still going through losing his mom. And today is Tisha's birthday. She's no longer here, but the family is, you know, taking the time to deal with the fact that it's her birthday, but she's not here to celebrate with them. So This week has been there's going to be weeks like this, man. It's going to be weeks like this where it's not just fun and laughter and you know what I mean? Sometimes it's serious shit. And again, today, I did not want to do a show. I woke up and said, fuck the show. I ain't doing a show today. I'm not doing a show today. Then after arguing with Cali Nuts all fucking morning to fix his fucking face, I care about him. He's my friend. I believe Vega was the same day. I believe it was the same day. I don't know if it was days prior. I believe it was the same day. Let me see if I can do that, Mel, while we're live. See, man, I'm going to try to do it, Mel. While we're live, let's see if it fucks up the show. If the show gets fucked up, it's because of Mel. But Mel could do no wrong today. Okay, Mel. Give me a second, guys, while I multitask. Hope everybody's having a good Wednesday, hump day, middle of the week. Hump day if it's in your mind like that, you know what I mean? But if not, it's just another day to make some money. That's what I say. Another day, another way to make some money. Hey, don't forget, it's 80s Wednesday. Fuck, man, I forgot to bring in the fucking video. And who am I going to blame for this? I'm going to blame Blue Label. Blaming Blue Label for all this shit that I got to do this shit live during the show. When Blue Label was supposed to remind me of, yo, we need to, if I could do this shit live, this is crazy that I could do it live. I gave it away. If you guys heard it, if you guys are dope with music, I gave you a half a second sound. Gave it away. I wasn't trying to give it away. Fuck, I gave it away. Give it away now. Okay, Mel Kwan, my brother from another. Done, Mel. Hey, what's going on? All right, let's get some fucking music. No, first, let's hear another song from the Soul Assassin albums. We'll be right back.
Shit. All right, come on. Where we at? 227. Sunday we make us a lot. Monday is robbers and thieves. Wednesday is get over the hump. Tuesday and Thursday we watch for the sweet. Friday, Saturday we rejoice. By ladies, good lady in the Royce. Late at night I repent for my sins. But every day I pray for Detroit. With them guns and that cane is in war. Know some youngest that's caging them wars. One day hopefully it'll sink in. All the trouble and pain that we caused. By my love of the game it was flawed. By the money, the chains and the cars. Cali weather, the weed and the women. 100 bands on my premium den. Rest to death. What up? All the clothes, the bricks and the balls. End of the day, it just mean that you win. Beat the case, he was guilty as charged. He think he can keep cheating the system. Who got better than me with conviction? No stress, never needed assistance. Old heads telling me that I'm gifted. I'm not better, just meaning I'm different. Got ahead of myself for a minute. I forgot for a second the reason I'm in it. Feds on the questioning, nigga. By my personal life, that ain't even my business. I never tell him myself, or nobody else for that matter. Caught him up, cross-examined the witness. Night serving two lights, had to handle his business. For his business, handle him. 30 clip in the FNN. Streets are taking some places you never been. So go tell a friend that this ain't no business to meddle in. Cause you can get this shit end up the stick. Not the handle, but the metal in.
Assassins. Say now, hey, mister, ain't trying to play with you. Don't pull up waving pistols unless you want these AKs to hit you.
Come on, man.
Assassins.
Take me out. Yeah. I got this. Back to back, BMW's 22 like it's me and those. I hit the 405's exit, La Tierra was brackable. I hit the 105 exit, Metro, you know I'm from the 2. Got Molly in the passenger sliding, don't make that nigga shoot. Pass the little bitch to my YG, I bet he tootin' mood. I hit the Riviera with Larry, I'm in a khaki suit. Looking like a nigga, sell cavi straight out of 92. I don't listen to no rap, that's it from 92. Mugs and cute, tear his mother up, watch me act a fool. West side bontin', hitting licks out of Bentley cool. Everybody thinking like Biggie, huh? Give me the loot. Take me out. Come on, man.
Say now, hey, mister. Ain't trying to play with you. Don't pull up waving pistols unless you want these AKs to hit you. Say now, hey, mister. Ain't trying to play with you. Don't pull up waving pistols unless you want these AKs.
That Bop Town, Northside Ingles, yeah. North. Bitch, I came from nothing, that money boosted up my ego, yeah. Free Primo, niggas get free smoke. Bust down, I doubt they own the type of time that we own.
Dead home,
and niggas better learn the lingo, yeah. Ain't no nice to meet you, this was bracket when I greet you, yeah. Antisocial, I don't really like to mingle. Give a fuck about your album, your freestyle, or your single, yeah. Mitch Mass Fashion, home film with the velo. Nigga made it out the dungeon like I'm CeeLo. One time for Big Gip, I be poppin' big shit. In the bitty, I'm a big deal, I keep this shit lit. I done took big risks to ball, I need my name on the jersey off them London drugs, it's just me and Jay Worthy. Yeah, production came from mugs, niggas can't afford to purchase. Put my dick on the pedestal, you bitches ain't worthy, nah.
Speed loader in a Magnum, and a scandalous 2006 Dodge Magnum. Road rage, you don't wanna see me out in traffic. I know magic, turn your head into an empty basket. She got lockjaw, all my bitches sexy and they nasty. Brazilian butt lifts, Brazilian waxes. One of them downtown, she plugged me with a jeweler for the cash in, she solid. She was my sponsor on my last bid. Product of fig, blame it on my environment. But now I'm in the stocks, property, multivitamins. Still a keeper, chopper or two, that's for the linemen. They hold the block down and duck the sirens.
Say now, hey, mister, ain't trying to play with you. Don't pull up waving pistols unless you want these AKs to hit you. Say now, hey, mister, ain't trying to play with you. Don't pull up waving pistols unless you want these AKs to hit you. Say now.
Greg, think of that album. Welcome back to another episode of the Power Hour. Mel Kwan will be joining us in about maybe 7 minutes. I don't know. Unfortunately, Clark will be joining us too. I gave my sound guy Jose the week off. He got to get his paperwork done. He's trying to get a valid ID, you know, a non-driver's ID. You know, I'll vouch for him. Some UK rapper beefing with Big Daddy Kane? Really? Wow. Stars Coleman album Pitbulls and Bears is official. Okay, we got to look at it. We got to look at it. We have to listen to it. No problem. Anyway, as you can see the title of today's show, somebody needs to tell Kanye West that you can't make these hoes into housewives. Now, somebody in 1986 in Queens was talking, and I was walking, and he said something to somebody else, and it just... He said, "Hey man, you can't make a hoe into a housewife." I said, "What?" So you can't make a hoe into a housewife. You can't make a hoe into a housewife. You can't make a hoe into a housewife. You can't, meaning you can't take a woman and make her a queen if she still wants attention from the villagers, right? And Kanye West has obviously lost his fucking mind. Kanye West is so far gone, so far gone, so far gone. I don't know what statistics you're talking about. I'm talking about street logic. I have no clue what statistics you know that says you can make a hoe into a housewife. Send me that shit. But this whole shit with Kanye getting head in a boat in Italy with his ass sticking out on the boat, you're fucking sloppy. You're disgraceful. You got daughters watching this shit that may grow up one day to take a boat ride with their husbands. And you know what daughters do? Daughters be like, they want to make their daddies happy. It's some sick fucking shit. You know what I mean? But the wildest chick strippers, they all have daddy issues. You know what I mean? But your daughters are watching this shit, you piece of shit. Seriously. Your daughters are watching this shit. And then Kim Kardashian is afraid that his daughter's watching Kanye with a whore of a wife may affect the daughter. Hey, how about having a whore of a mother? How do you think that's going to affect your daughter's fucking psychology? When the kids that are hating on their wealth say, "Well, you know your mother is a whore. Like, she really has no talent. She just sucked dick." I mean, Somebody's going to say that to them, right? You can't isolate these kids. You can't protect them from haters and trolls. It's too late, right? Every troll in the fucking world, every fucking loser behind a keyboard and a fucking camera that can hide their identity behind an avatar. See, that's why I have no respect for these podcasters that just videotape other people's shows and don't show themselves, just talk about other people's videos. You're not a podcaster, dude. I'm just telling you that right now. There's no way you're a fucking podcaster. You're disgraciado. It's disgusting. Oh, there's nothing wrong with your wife. Exactly, Bats. I believe that's what I said on a comment. There's nothing wrong with your wife giving you a head, and a good wife swallows. But you're Kanye West, man. And for some reason, you're just addicted to shocking people, but you're also shocking your children, you know? Everybody knows a good woman swallows. It's a time and place for everything. Now, if you're nobody, and I'm not saying that in a bad way, because nobody's nobody, you know? I'm sure everybody's got their joint copped in a movie theater at one point in their life. Salute to the girls that'll cop your joint in a movie theater. God bless them. It's beautiful. But you got this is how fucked up the shit is. You got daughters that are watching this that you don't give a fuck about. And your wife, your ex-wife, who's a certified professional whore, is worried about the damage that it will do to the kids because of Kanye's new whore wife, right? See, guys want their cake and eat it too. So guys want a good girl, but they want the slut. They want the good girl who's going to be a slut. It's very hard to find the good girl that's going to be a slut for you. They're there. It's hard. Either they're completely slut or they're just a totally good girl, right? No, it's more about the weirdo. It's more about the weirdos. It's really about protecting your kids to this shit. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, okay, look, in a way, I believe that most normal people, most dysfunctionally normal people, are sex addicts. I'm a sex addict. I love, who does, you know, which man doesn't love some trim, right? Kanye West is a sex addict with a lot of fucking money, and he's a Gemini, and he's bipolar. He's fucking nuts. You're nuts. You're going to ruin your kid's life over this shit. It's crazy. Hey, JPS in the building. What's going on? What's going on there, General JPS? Let's get some background fucking music, man. Can't turn a hoe into a house, man. God. Hey, where's this, that's Vic Vega. Oh, wait, is today snitching Thursday? Because I got a snitch on Vega. You can't be famous out there with your brown ass all over the boat like that. With your brown fucking ass showing. You got your wife on her knees copping your joint. Oh, it's tomorrow. Okay. Oh, it's Wednesday. I thought it was snitching Thursday. Snitching on Vic tomorrow on some bullshit he did months ago. I go back on my snitching. I go back. I got files. But it was funny what he did, though. It wasn't like I'm snitching on what he did. You know what I mean? I'm not snitching on him. I am, but 80s Wednesday. 80s Wednesdays. 80s Wednesdays. So I got a good 80s track anyway. What's up, my guy?
What's up, my guy?
How you feeling, my guy? You hear the seriousness in my voice? There ain't no joy in my voice today, though. See what I'm saying? There's no laughter in my voice. There's no excitement in my voice. Today's that, you know, that deep voice, that, yo, what up, man? That's how I'm feeling, man.
Life been much better than this.
I know, man.
But you're not. Therapeutic for the user.
It is therapeutic. This is therapeutic. This is why I do this. It's only one thing that motherfucking lemur-looking motherfucker academic said correctly. Okay? Because we all know academics looks like the lemur from Madagascar.
Fact.
Okay? Fact. He said that for some people, podcasting is therapeutic. And I'm here to tell you, for me and Melquan, it really is.
It really is.
Boy. You know why? Because me and Melquan are the last two from the whole gang that you see on the screen every day. Because we need it the most.
It's a fact.
It's true. And there's nothing to be shameful about it.
Not at all, man.
Nothing. It really makes our life, we feel better when we do the show. Correct?
Correct.
You don't feel better when
I was on the move going to the store. Yeah. I was like, you know what? I saw you in the threat. He was like, yo, follow hour. I was like,
Power hour.
I need this.
Yeah, power hour. It's just fucking therapeutic. Fuck numbers. I need to get shit off my soul sometimes, man.
Yo, salute to everybody.
Good morning. How about that? Salute to everybody. So what's good, Mel? You want to talk? You don't feel like talking? You want to smoke? You want to sip? I'm here to chill with you, bro.
Yesterday was hard, man. And salute to everybody that was calling me yesterday. I didn't mean to dub everybody. I was just...
Oh, I'm glad you dubbed everybody.
No, there's certain people I text.
I ain't even call him. Yes. I don't even want to bother him. I already know how he's feeling.
You know what I'm saying? It's like...
He told me Monday, yo, let your boy be, man. I said, okay, just be careful. You know, once he says, let me be, just be careful. I ain't got to check in.
Mm-hmm. And I just chilled, man. I just chilled and Just me and my son, because my daughter's there away for the week. I'll see them till Sunday. So.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, me and my son, we just took it light, just chilled at the crib, you know what I mean? We just chilled and we reminisced. So, you know, salute to Tisha, man. Word up. Virgo in the house, you hear me? My lady was a Virgo too. Crazy.
Ah, it's difficult, man. It's
crazy difficult. Was serious.
You know, I would never say nothing wrong about Tisha, but Virgo.
No, Virgo, man. Women are the
worst. Bobby Bonner is a Virgo.
Yeah, that's my
Mr. Player. Mr. O-O-K.
He's up, Bobby.
Mr. O-O-K is my Jewish best friend in the whole world.
He's a Virgo?
No, his mother's a Virgo, and she's a terrorist, dog.
Yeah.
Terrorist.
Salute. We don't play no games.
His brother's a Virgo. Impossible to deal with.
Virgo rule the world, baby.
Virgos give me high blood pressure, baby. That's what
no, you Geminis get on my nerves. My cousin, I was ready to break his jaw yesterday.
You watch your fucking mouth,
fucking
man.
June 8th, niggas. Keep knocking at my goddamn door.
Oh, you better watch your fucking mouth.
Yeah, that nigga gets on my nerves.
You a Virgo? Tell me you're a Virgo, because that makes all the sense in the world, nipple lips.
Yo, salute,
tell
Cali.
Tell me you a Virgo, Cali Nuts. Then we really got to get that face fixed. I wake up in the morning and I wake up in the morning and I text Cali. I'm like, yo. He's like, what's up? I'm like, yo, fix your face.
Fix your face.
See, that's your real face. Friendship right there. We don't even know each other. You're a Virgo, Cali? I gotta say, for a Virgo, you're mad cool, though, Cali. You're mad cool. You're nothing like Bobby Banner. You're nothing like my boy's brother or mother. You're very
cool, baby.
For a
Virgo. Cali, that's Virgo. Why you cool.
For a Virgo.
They can't handle our they can't handle our chemistry. They can't handle our mouth.
I don't know about all that. You may be chemically off balance. But I don't know about your chemistry. Virgos may be chemically off balance.
We run the block.
I got no damn coffee, no electrolytes. I put up 5 miles today, Melquan. What do you feel about that?
Wow, you're not doing 5 minutes, sir.
I did 5 miles today, sir.
Turn the music down a little bit. Snap back to reality. Thank you. Thank you, Simon. Thank you, Simon. He ain't doing no fucking 5 miles. He doing 5 miles in his V. It's like a blue label. Say, I look like Michael Jai White today. That's my man. You know, I found out, speaking of him, that he really is a karate expert. I thought he just knew
he
that
ain't
shit.
No joke.
Yeah, he fucks niggas up for real, for real.
He will fuck people up.
For real, for real. I was oh shit.
My dog's in the hospital. Go fix your face, nipple lips. Can't be walking around with lips that look like nipples.
Oh, they kept her?
They did the surgery last night.
Oh.
She on the fentanyl drip right now.
She like this.
She like, yeah.
She's like, your dogs ain't higher than me, son.
You know, she's not feeling it.
Is
right
she going to recover good and everything?
Yeah, the success, the surgery was a success. The doctor that did the surgery did her left leg. Right leg is done. I believe in this doctor. Dr. Valdez is a Puerto Rican, a great Puerto Rican vet. And, he said I could pick her up early or I could choose to keep her on the drip longer. I said, let her enjoy the drip.
Yeah, let her ride that shit out, son.
Let her get suited. After the show, I'm going to go buy a new bed at Petco and then go pick her up.
Yeah?
That's it. I'll put the bed in the car and then put her right into the bed. You know what I mean? Say, get it done. That's all.
Yeah. That's what's up, man.
Yeah, man.
So, as long as you get better, man.
Yeah. $3,600 down. Raped.
You better send your dog to social service. They drop Kai off at social service. So I go get some food stamps or some shit.
No,
damn,
this girl, she's next. Yo, she ain't ever running with the wolves again. It's going to be short leash walking, no jumping down from anything, nothing, nothing. Nothing from now to the day she leaves me is you live. She's
everything,
a wild
she gotta
dog.
Be
she
got the ground level.
She's 1/4 pit. That pit makes her go crazy, dog.
Yeah.
She's 3/4 Jack Russell, 1/4 pit.
Especially if you pass gas, you know the dog be going crazy. So she ain't got nowhere to run. She can't jump down and protect herself. She be like,
I'm gonna let you slide
that shit.
I'm gonna
let
Can I tell you the truth?
Yeah.
When you used to do that, I used to get so mad.
Yeah. I forgot to check on something.
Fuck you. I wanted to fuck you up. And then I would be mad at the dog. Like, why are you barking to this to me?
As soon as somebody passed my wrist, the dog be like,
no, I'll give you a wrench. The fucking one is what that orange.
Yo, I swear to God, I'm not gonna lie. Inside my soul, yeah. Fuck it, I know.
I love it.
But I'm never gonna get mad on the air and get you happy.
My job is to piss you the fuck off.
I think one time you caught me.
Yeah, you went berserk.
Because everybody was making fun of you in the room, and you fed the system, and you made fun of me too. And I'm like, yo, but they all making fun of you. Why are you making fun? I was so
hated. I was like, yes, I did my job.
I was like, why the fuck you picking on me when they picking on you?
It's not about me. It's you now.
I was like, that ain't right.
You gotta love it. I love it. Yeah, salute to all the parents that got school clothes out the way. Salute to you guys.
Yo, salute to the fact that New York City bus drivers may be going on strike on the first day of school to fuck everything up for the parents. Let's go.
The school bus drivers?
Let's go.
That's gonna suck. That's gonna suck.
Oh yeah, man.
Oh, that's gonna suck. See, out of Long Island, you can't go on strike. Like, in the city, at least you still got the mass transit. The shit out here, boy, I wish you would shut the bus.
Mel, do the bark again.
Rah, 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 let's stop that shit, Rush. I'm going to get to her, let's get real.
I used to be, yo, in my soul, I used to be like, fucking dog barks at every fucking noise.
I love it.
Like, what the fuck you doing, Rich?
I'm like, Rich Martin, guys. He just drove
the
dog.
And then I'm trying to shut the mic off before Mel hears
something. Like, what the fuck you doing, Rich?
I don't care what you're going through in life, I hate you for that. We'll figure it out. We keep going.
Yo, I'm mad right now.
I want to fucking work that right.
Because he sounds just like the fucking dog.
That's how she was, yo. As soon as yo. As soon as you pass my rich crib, the sensor go on. So the shit go, or whatever, the dog go, she goes berserk. I'm like, oh, shit, Rich must have, he must have farted again.
He's like, stop that shit, Rich, shut that fucking door. No.
The first time the dog barked, Mel Kwan goes, oh, Rich must have shitted. And everybody lost their fucking mind. And I was so hurt and angry.
I was like, yo, torture his ass.
That shit was so funny.
Yeah, you supposed to do 80s Wednesdays.
It is 80s Wednesday. I got a song.
My 80s song for the Walk This Way. I'm doing it for next week. Walk This Way. Run DMC
This Way? Wow. Okay. Mm-hmm. Next Wednesday, Walk This Way.
Mm-hmm.
How long did we ban Blue Label for picking music for not showing up for that Wednesday?
For the rest of the year.
For the rest of the year, Blue Label. Hold that L. Yeah. We're two L's up, Mr. Polo. Yeah, no. Hold the two L's up, Mr. Polo. Clark is trying to get in, but because of the hurricane, his Wi-Fi is iffy.
Yo, and I ain't going front. I'm still doing free promotion on the street. If it wasn't for Blue Label, I probably wouldn't even heard of Conway and all those cats from Buffalo. And I spread the word a little bit on Long Island, and now people be then I'm like, I told y'all niggas. Then now they won't give me my credit. Like, yo, son, you ain't heard them first.
Well, no,
I'm like, I did. I'm gonna
tell you something.
No, I don't know what everybody
you
else heard.
Been
I didn't hear
accepting
it.
Credit that is not yours for 17 yo, years now.
I put out, if it wasn't for Blue Label, I put niggas on the Conway, Benny the Butcher. Niggas ain't even know them niggas, son. They ain't even heard of them. And I'm like, yo, you got to listen to these cats from upstate. And boom, them niggas is lit.
Yo, I love Girls, Girls, Girls by Motley Crue. Girls, Girls, Girls. I like that shit. When in Rome, we'll check that out. When we'll check that out. We'll check that out.
Girls just want to have fun.
That's my shit. The Message. All right. Cindy Lauper's my biatch.
Oh,
love me some Cindy.
Oh yeah, I used to love me some Cindy Lauper. You know,
well,
she
was
a part of the first WrestleMania.
Cindy Lauper, Madonna. What about Sheila E. Sheena Easton?
Oh, son,
come on.
That's why my wifey was light skinned. I'm addicted to light.
You like that? You like that red
I
bone?
Like
high
no
yellow, high yes. Yellow red bone. Yeah,
not no more. You not gotta no be. More. You gotta be blacker than Wesley Snipes or white on rice.
White on rice.
Yeah. Light skin.
Oh, no
is
more
dead.
In between, huh?
No, no more light skin. My wife killed that shit.
So blacker than Wesley or whiter than rice?
Yep. That's where it is at right now.
And when you come at me, bring me some Rio Needy on ice twice.
Light skin women. I love Sheila E. Apollonia.
Apollonia.
They
good
were the
God
baddest.
Of mercy.
Oh my God.
Apple, I used to be, yo, Apollonia, mm-hmm. I didn't even know what to do with her, but I would fantasize about having her. I don't know.
Especially in the, what was that, Purple Rain? Remember, she had on, no, she had her own song. She had on this white veil shit, like sexy with the white gloves and the, yo, I used to be like,
okay, now Vic Vegas said, you look like a fucking maniac. Talking one direction,
Samantha
your hands
Fox.
In the other direction.
Oh my God, Cali.
Samantha
you
Fox.
You speaking my language, Brody.
Paula Abdul.
Paula Abdul.
Madonna. Justify My Love, Madonna.
Lisa, Lisa.
Lisa, Lisa.
Oh man, Arsenio back in the day.
Arsenio was smashing Paula Abdul, son. Had her when she was right.
Mm-hmm. Paula Abdul was
God. That must be Arsenio's greatest conquering, right? Like greatest notch on the belt. Like he sits there and look in the mirror and be like,
Arsenio don't be out there though.
I fuck Paula Abdul though, but come on, man,
you don't be out there like that.
You don't think he be gassed like that? All right,
he was gassed because they was at the Lakers games all the time. They used to catch him.
Vic Vega sent in a $2 donation. Thank you, Vic Vega. Mel, what goes on your head and rhymes with rap? That's right, sir. He's calling you out. He's saying your cap. There you go, sir. That's what he meant by the donation, and that's what he's saying.
You're just lucky that you don't live in New York. So. And me and you are supposed to fight every day. So. Like he's like your little brother. You gotta fight him every day. You gotta throw your shit up every day with your little brother. And the sound just went tremendously loud, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're touching too much shit, sir.
No. I raised the volume up so we can do the applause could be heard.
Clark, where are you?
Clark can't make it in.
No, work. Oh. Dead Times Limited. Paul Rocks, too. He killed that shit.
Lisa Bonet. Oof.
Oh, man.
Oh.
I go front. My
Where's
ultimate,
the Jergens?
My ultimate crush. Oh,
my God. Jasmine Guy. Jasmine Guy, kind of scary. Wait a minute.
Nah,
what
Jasmine
about my
Guy
honey
was
Mary?
Fly, son.
I don't know. Jasmine?
Jasmine God was fly, son.
I don't know.
My man Tupac came close to
us. I was going to say that she was a little handsome.
Ah, come on,
she
bro.
Was a little handsome.
She's that Southern Belle.
She was a Southern Belle, but she was a little handsome Belle.
I liked her, man. You but know? My favorite crush is Janet Jackson.
Janet Jackson.
Janet Jackson taught me how to be a young man.
How did she teach you how to be a young man?
Certain songs like "Let's Wait a While." Don't rush the girl. If she not a hoe, don't rush her. People,
It's too late. Let's wait a while.
You know what? I don't know, but everything about you, you're like a ladies man. You protect the ladies, bro.
Let's wait a while.
Yeah,
just wait. Why? Just wait there while you got blue balls for three fucking days, right?
No, that means she a good girl. Wait there while you got blue balls,
and you gotta back up, and you get backed up. Then you gotta go and fucking jerk off, and then she's like, "I'm ready." Right after you, because
if you give me the buns right away, you know what I mean? Shit gonna happen. You talk about young Melquan. I would have been like,
salute to the men that appreciate a woman that give up the buns right away. Come on, man. Come on, man. Mm-mm. What is wrong with
what
you?
What she said
man?
At the end of the song. It's like, I'll be worth the wait. I was like, yes, baby. Pam Grier, that's what I'm talking about. Yo, Janet Jackson was the flyest chick, son.
Let's wait a while.
The girl with the hump in The Witcher is gorgeous. What is her name? Arya? I forgot what her name is. Not Arya. That's from Game of Thrones.
I go
fine. Yennefer.
I like Shorty from, what's that shit on Netflix where the dude, he's a stalker and he tried to make it into a love story? You ever seen that shit? It's a one syllable word.
Yo, Blue Label, I would hit it with the hump. Don't tell nobody.
But Shorty's gorgeous on there with a blondie.
I'd hit Yennefer with the hump and the fucking chin. I don't give a fuck. I don't know why. She's just hot.
Yo, son, you know who be trying to push up on me? The lady at the Chinese restaurant. I think I'm about to go Oriental, too. She got to give us a...
Stop, bitch. She wants you to spend more money.
She's holding.
Oh, Mia was dope.
Mia was dope. Mia jumped out the way.
Mia was nice.
They were trying to get up. They was trying to get her.
Blue Label said, I'll hump that hump. I'm like, come here, man. Let me just rub my joystick on that hump.
Meal of the day. Get your soup game up, y'all.
What you got? What's that? Wonton?
Shrimp and corn chowder.
Nice.
With a bunch of vegetables. Man, this is a good shit, boy.
Vegetables?
Vegetables.
I hear you. You got to get your vegetables. Mm-hmm. Got to get them in. Let's hear some more music from the Soul Assassins 3 album.
Oh, yeah. The first joint was what?
That's the middle of the album. You missed yesterday's show.
Beat was hard. Sounds like hip hop.
Never done though, if I'ma run, I'ma never run slow. Treble down in the bass up, I let the record rumble. Kindness for weakness, I've been extra fucking humble. What can I say? I'm a man of many moments. A lot of shit I do, I don't condone it. Fuck opponents. If it's beef, it's gonna be with owners. You ain't seen me for a minute, I've been recomposing. Back to recap the benefits of being chosen. Accountable for what I say now. I'm stubborn, even if there's fire, I don't stay down. Cut the vocal, then I ride it through the Greyhound. I'm a master mixer, surfers up and waves round. Doing good when they were up, but not the way down. Burn the playbook, fuck what they cook, what they found. Some kids my son shouldn't play around. Summertime in LBC, been on the playground.
Rich is lying, guys.
I unearth some shit to dead it after this. My heaven off the devil chapter. Illest nigga at work, check the metadata. I don't lose sleep over moments that never happen. I'm the answer to the question askers. This shit is personal. Push a ton of weight to make the summer look so surgical. Taught niggas how to surf off of these waves that I give birth to. Squares about my circle for the curvature. Nothing special about it, just a role reversal. Now looking first, I'm in that pace. My energy's enough, respect the space I'm in. No swerving, we 180 it. Ain't like nobody, I must be some type of alien. Don't ever play yourself, check who you playing with. I was down with the surface with the dirtiest slides. So trust, I still ain't met nobody worthy of mine. Shot a hole into they plans, is how I'm furthering mines. Arrived too late to be this early in time. I can't explain it.
That's right.
Hey, play that again.
Been soul assassin, what's happening, niggas know.
Magic mushroom. Magic mushroom.
Psilocybin mushrooms for thousands of years. In traditional practices and for medicinal purposes, the Aztecs called these sacred mushrooms astonishing gifts from the gods.
That well-controlled study showed large, rapid, and enduring decreases in depression and anxiety after a single session with psilocybin.
Thousands of new connections form, linking brain regions that don't normally talk to each other.
That would be all I was interested in, the edibility. The economic factor, you know, I can sell this mushroom and make money.
This one's definitely sellable.
More energy.
This is so important because I think psilocybin is an Einstein moment.
Assassin.
For real, Vic, I got lost in that. That was dope. I didn't know that they had a commercial for mushrooms, but that was fucking trippy. And if you were listening to that shit, they were talking about Aztecs saying that mushrooms were a gift to the god. And if you were further listening, you were saying that, and this is a proven fact, that psychedelic mushrooms connect parts of your brain that don't normally connect and rebuild neural pathways that have been destroyed. This is all scientific fact. And for that guy to say that mushrooms is the Einstein particle, that's fucking crazy. Never heard it like that.
Yo, don't fuck with mushrooms, son. That mushrooms shit had me bugging out. I was in the mall.
Yeah?
This is my worst mushroom story.
You got to come over and watch Tron with me.
No. I think it was like 2 years we trying to get me to do shrooms and watch Tron with you.
Yo, come over and watch Tron with me, no. Dude.
Yo, son, I didn't
shroom. No, I don't care. We're going to set up cameras and we're going to do shrooms, bro. And watch Tron, bro.
Bro, that shit had... Fuck, I can't, yeah, fuck with shrooms. Yo,
yeah,
that,
you can. Yeah, you
yo,
can.
Yo, bro, I did shrooms. Me and my boy Jimmy from Long Island, World Bar. We was at the bar. We was bugging the fuck out because he was sitting across from me and we kept going... I was like, yo, Jimmy, pick up, man. I can't move. Look. Yo, the whole bar looking at us. Then I just got up and left. I started walking through the neighborhood. I wound up at the mall. I thought the ceiling from the mall, like the sunroof shit, I thought it was falling. So I'm in the food court going like this. I'm like, yo, and then my boy, he found me in the mall. He like, what the fuck are you doing? I was like, yo, son, the ceiling ain't falling. He like, nah, what the fuck is you doing? I was like, yo, don't fuck with shrooms, son.
Let's do shrooms and watch Tron.
Tripping. I can't.
The first one too, man.
I can't trip.
Dude, you don't understand. Tron is the original Matrix.
Fuck that, son. I'll stick to the bud. That's my shit. That bass line is dope. Along that.
First thing, man, when it hits you, feel no pain. White man says no pain. There's a right, there's a pain. There's no better rest.
That shit hard. Yeah, that shit hard. That everybody be up.
Yeah, yup. You got a club crunk with this shit.
What you smoking all today?
You know me, as always, every day, there's another way, but we never say no to that Top Dog Sour. You want to know the first time I took shrooms where I was? in Amsterdam. And the first time I took shrooms, I went to the movies. And you know what I saw tripping on shrooms? Snatch. Top Shelf Sour Diesel. We know that Top Shelf is flop shelf.
I know, but for $25,
oh my
this
God,
time it really tastes like
I can't
like
believe
sour.
You paying.
I was on the move. I was on the move. Shorty was like, yo, son, I got that. I was like, me too. I get that shit all day, every day. He's like, nah, son, I got it.
I was like, "Word, let me see what you got here."
Because I get the little shorties, point. They got blood. They be like, "Yo, son, I got that blood." I be like, "No, you don't." They be like, "Nah, for real. This, that, what's the name?" I be like, "Nah."
No perks for me, Callie. No perks. No Xannies. No Vicodins. None of that shit.
Nah, no pills. God,
fucking no pills, man.
Out of here.
Only natural grown weed, natural grown shrooms, and wine from the most delicious grapes. Nature's medicine.
Yo, that pill shit fucked the game up.
Pill shit fucked everything up.
Well, a lot of people that's really fucked up off that shit.
But you know, if you can do a little bit and enjoy, then you know.
All right, just smoke some bud, eat some bud, drink some vodka. Drink some Jameson, you know what I mean?
He may take perks for his face, you know what I mean?
Pull the fuck back. You turn your music up and just drop, man. You know what I mean? Fuck all that other shit.
Oh, yeah, I see. Cal uses it for the gym or his face.
The gym.
Yeah, Cali's a big boy, dude.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, yeah, I seen a picture of him, I think, when he was in DR sitting down. He's a fucking beast.
I know. And he be balling, he travels a lot. I'm hating.
Of course you're hating.
I'm hating. I don't go nowhere.
Where do you like? You go to the store.
To the supermarket.
You go to do laundry.
To the school.
And the discussion. And the school. That's it. That's all he goes. That's where he goes.
Yeah. I'll pop up in the city here and there.
Or in Brooklyn sometimes.
Yeah. I'm stuck. Well, you know, I'm a dad, man.
Hey, no, listen, you're one of the greatest dads ever. One of the greatest dads ever, man.
And I can't let go of the 90s.
Mentally, you're my hero, Melquan.
Man, salute you. You're a boss, bro.
Nah, I'm lying. No, so, I'm just trying. You are my hero, dude. You are. Because I always tell you this, man. We became friends and your life was hit with tragedy and we've grown as friends through that shit. Tragedy and pain, and what I see is a man that has dealt with a lot and is still smiling and standing, and that, my friend, makes you so amazing, bro, than a lot of people that don't even go through your shit and don't even understand what they got, don't even understand how amazing their life is. And here you are walking through fire for 5 years and still walking through fire. And still you ain't fall down. Still, yeah, you keep continuing.
Gotta keep going. That's the one thing my mother told me before she died. She's like, "Dang it." So then just stand there.
Now, Vic Vega, he actually sent in a picture for the show so he could show everybody how brolic he was in case he had to slap people for money.
Oh, God. You know, I'm hating on him because I hope as soon as he go through the luggage part, the grab part, the handle just break off.
You see, I stick up for Cali, and what does this Virgo nipple lip fix your face fuck do? He goes, "No, we're sending naked selfies to each other."
Yeah.
Fucking traitor.
That's right. We have a valid point.
We got to get some new instrumentals up in here, man. For real. We need some new shit, man. I'm gonna play this because this always reminds me of the Junkyard Dog.
That was JYD. Do you watch any other A&E? If anybody out there, y'all watch the A&E, they have these documentaries about the old school wrestling. And watch the stories, they got Junkyard Dog.
That's dope.
Rest in peace to my man Bray Wyatt.
Oh, yeah, there's some wrestler just died.
The Fiend. I don't know if anybody watched wrestling. The Fiend, he was like the new wave Undertaker. And
how'd he die, man?
They didn't say, they just say he was
drugs killed. Or heart?
Heart, probably. And like that's another thing. Joe Rogan got it.
Jesus.
Joe Rogan,
golly nuts, you are crazy.
Yo, Joe Rogan did a podcast with Hulk Hogan talking about why do wrestlers die so young? You got to look what they put themselves through to entertain motherfuckers or boo you. You know what I'm saying? Boo them or cheer for them or buy their merch. And I've been watching that shit since '83. My great grandmother said, "Yo, turn on channel 11 in New York."
She like, turn on wrestling.
Wrestling.
I was like, what the fuck is
come wrestling? Come here, boy, you want to wrestle?
Wrestle. She's from Baltimore. She's like, yo, come on, wrestle.
Locked up for real, for real. That's jail talk right there, Kylie.
That's crazy. I used to run with his pops when I was younger. Mike Rotundo. That's his son. And Terry Funk died. Terry Funk died too.
That's what I was about to say.
He was one of the toughest SOBs ever. Terry Funk
was no joke coming in like, with that leather vest.
Yeah.
That black leather vest first, with the cowboy hat.
Mm-hmm. And remember, he used to have the
cowboy brand Bob Orton.
No, Bob Orton used to have the cast on his arm. He used to run with Roddy Piper. That was my man too. Meisty. That's when wrestling was really wrestling. Now it's entertainment. But I mean, they kids now run their shit. No word.
Hey, if anybody's looking for a good stock to get into, NVIDIA is no fucking joke.
Bro, nobody's taking your advice.
Listen to me. NVIDIA in 1 year is up $348. These companies are making AI chips. So that means if you invested $100 a year later, you have $400. So imagine if somebody invested $100,000 a year later, they'd have $400,000, Melquan. So if somebody invested $1 million in 1 year, they'd have $4 million, Melquan. This company is making AI chips, and I buy every day, and I'm making money every day on NVIDIA. It's crazy.
On NVIDIA? See, it's cool. Then you got to realize, too, man, they about to take all the green paper away. Everything about to be cards. And I mean, it ain't going to be no money.
I would say over 3-4 years of investing, I probably lost like 25 grand. But you got to lose. You got to lose. You got to lose to win, Cali. What the fuck? But I ain't been losing like that. I've been winning little by little, little by little. I've been winning.
You lost bad last year.
Like a year and a half ago, I fucking listened to Clark, man. And we fucked, man. Fuck.
Last year. That's why I was like.
But I can't blame Clark. I blame me.
Because I couldn't even get my 20. I put $20 in, the shit ain't even go over $200.
You ended up, owing them $3 after.
Word, I took the shit out. I owed them $3. I was like, what the fuck? Fuck this shit. They had some shit you could do over your phone. I was like, you know what?
I can never blame Clark for listening to Clark. Everybody like, you motherfucker, I listen. No, that's exactly right.
Clark is smart with them stock tips.
No, he's fucking not. He's a fucking idiot. He got fat on the fucking brain.
No.
Clark, are you fucking crazy? I've watched this man lose fucking G-notes.
I know Clark's on that shit.
No. I'm not saying
it's just you're a loser.
Yeah, exactly. I knew you were going to say that. Yeah, Clark's the winner.
Yeah.
And I'm the loser.
Yes.
We're talking about a stock that's up 349% in 1 year. Fuck, I'm telling you, put some spare money into NVIDIA and leave it there. Yeah, Clark is laughing. He knows how much money we lost. Let me tell you how fucking stupid I am. I'm so fucking stupid that I'm listening to Clark, who's listening to some fucking woman who dresses up like a fucking chicken on YouTube and is giving stock advice. I swear you, take me and fucking shoot me. That's how stupid I am.
Look at your surroundings, sir. Were you chicken?
Look at my surroundings. Look at your window curtains.
Oh, no, it's the cover up because I hate the sun. I threw that cover up. And that cover is special. So I rock with it.
Nah, I know.
I'm really making a lot of changes.
Well, let me guess. You're drinking more.
No. I don't drink. We're going this way.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12:34 p.m. on August 30th, Melquan says he does not drink. Okay. So what kind
this
of changes,
afternoon?
What kind of changes are you making if not for drinking more, sir?
Because I've been looking for cribs, man.
Oh, right.
The market is like, yo, when it's time to cross the finish line, it's some bullshit. I'd be like, yo, nah, man.
So it's some bullshit, right?
So I'm like, you know what? Because I just want to get out of this crib because of everything. You know what I mean? But
you need a fresh start.
Right. You know what I'm saying? So I just figured, you know what? Maybe just wait till next year or something with it. Because I know the market's up heavy right now.
Market's up heavy?
Yeah, but it's gonna go back down, especially through the winter. So, you know what I mean? So I'm going to just re-gut my whole career. I'm about to throw all this shit out.
Yeah, you know, I swear to God, a dude like me, if I hit the lotto, I'd buy a giant piece of property and build houses for my peoples.
And give it to them. Yeah,
and give it to
lotto,
them.
I'll be
and you know why? So this way we could me and my peoples, we could be, you know, we could all chill forever till we die. You know, and guarantee you give them a great situation like that, and all my people's wives will come in and fuck up the whole situation.
Wow, see,
that's what women do.
I will build a little projects, a little condos. Everybody just chill. Everybody I fuck with will be up in one. I'm like, yo, boom. And then put some gates around it. I'm gonna have armed security at the gate. You getting hit. You come up to my shit wrong.
And you know what it is? I want to play louder. I want to play every day just one time, right? Because you can't win if you don't play, right? And I forget to play.
I won $12 last week.
But if the universe lets me win, I guarantee you, I will just keep enough for what I need, and I would build all my friends' houses. You never have to. I would buy the land and build the house. So none of my friends have to pay for housing ever again for the rest of their lives. And they can give that to their children, and their children, they could just pass it down from generation to generation. That's what I would do.
Nah, fuck that.
Because I don't need that much to live. I'm literally, I just need a land to, listen, here's what I want. If I hit the lotto, right? I want organic, healthy food. I want every type of weed strain grown in my property. And different women every day, because if I was a millionaire, I wouldn't need to get married. There's be no sense to getting married. Married is for people that don't have money. And I would have money, and I would have a different girlfriend every day, like Drake. Yeah, what about you, Melquan? A different girlfriend every day if you were a millionaire?
No.
Or would you settle down and get married and then get divorced and have her take
your
money?
I would pick one out the crowd and be like, you.
Clear. No, you do it R. Kelly style.
You. Like, you look, come on. I got you. And then I'm not getting married. Well, yeah, fuck that. I'm not getting married.
Yeah, I'll give you an example.
You want to ride? Come on down.
I'll give you an example of how chicks will fuck up a situation with free housing. I know five brothers. Beautiful brothers that love each other. Okay. They all got married. And when I tell you that they moved like a fist, my nigga, right? They all got married, and all five of their wives bickered so badly that none of the brothers talked to each other. So I would literally give my people housing and all that shit and sit back and look at it as a fucking experiment.
That's what you're wrong. It's not the women's fault. It is the women's fault.
And it's also the brothers' fault for not handling their business and settling down their women.
I'm about to say,
letting
first of all,
bicker with each other.
Like, yo, you're not supposed to have that shit. We family. There ain't no beefing amongst each other. If you don't like each other, then just stay away.
Five brothers moved like one, bro. And me and my boys sat back. And when we went to their family functions and weddings and all that shit, we would just sit back and be like, yo, look, one brother's over there. One brother's over there. Me and my boy would just look. One brother's over there.
And I said,
look at that. Five brothers that don't talk to each other because they can't keep their bitches in check. What a fucking shame.
Yeah.
Such a shame.
And they can't check to each other. So they went out like bitches too. It's like, yo, we brothers. The fuck our wives. Let's start from there. Fuck our wives for a second. Okay, we brothers. We don't do all that. But at the same time, me and my brother don't get along.
My dude, each one of their wives poisoned the brother's fucking mind, not because they're poisonous, because they each saw the weakness in each of them that they could manipulate and control. and eat. They got each one of them to stop talking. Do you know how fucking hard that is to do? Mm-hmm. To get five men, not just to act. Yo, that's fucking crazy. But
yeah, shit's crazy.
Women could do that. Women could do that. Mm-hmm. They could. They could. Mm-hmm. You know? But that's what I would do if I would win the lotto. That's why I'm like, yo, the universe should let me win the lotto. Because well, I'm not going to keep it for myself.
I'm going to have my little cat. It's going to be my...
Bye.
I'm out. I'll call you. Don't call me. I ain't going to have no phone. So I'm going to take the numbers who I need, and my phone is going in the river. I'm going to never have a cell phone.
You're going to have to talk to a representative of mine before talking to me. Forget phone. Yeah. I will never hold a gadget again.
Email me.
I wouldn't get it. My representative would get it.
I'm going to go back to two-way pager.
I would disconnect myself from everything electronic and let the people I hire deal with all that shit. There's no emails, there's no text messages, there's no phone calls, there's no GPS, there's no tracking. Rich is free, truly free.
Oh man. I'm gonna build a wall around my.
About to get a brisket sandwich. Oh, that sounds delicious.
I know. I'm about to take my soup up. I gotta hit the road too, man.
Where you going, homie?
Man, I gotta go take care of some BI and see what's up.
You want my Oculus? $400.
No, I don't want that shit.
No,
so you almost had a seizure.
$400.
Seizures with that shit. Everything was just too. I'm like, oh,
that Oculus shit is dope, but just like everything, I have such a short attention span, and I'm like, you bore me, and I look for something else.
No, I seen the
Oculus. Now I'm learning less is more. I really don't listen, man. Get up in the morning, walk outside, breathe that fucking air. Life is good, man. You're alive.
More school you can supports. Think.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, this shit is retarded. Good. They send the list yesterday.
Good.
She started in high school, bro. I'm like, God damn, man. She grew up so fast. But they sent the list for every other grade except for the high school. So I gotta go on a website and do all this shit. I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
Say
just,
word.
Just tell me what you need. You gotta go to certain stores to find shit. Like this shit crazy. It ain't like back in the days. We went right on Graham Ave in Brooklyn. Everything was right there on Fat Albert's. Remember that store, Fat Albert?
No.
Fuck out of here. You don't remember Fat Albert?
Fat Albert's a store?
Yeah. It used to be like a discount store, like a 99.
I remember motherfuckers used to call me Fat Albert. They'd be like, hey, here comes Fat Albert.
He used to be this kid in my projects. He looked like,
my name's Richard Perec, man.
It was this kid in my projects. He looked like Bucky, the one with the big ass lips.
Yo, they said Blue Label, ain't nobody ask you about your coleslaw just because you can't pick 80s music no more. We know you feel bad.
He's bad.
We know you feel bad. Now you want to throw some jalapeno on the coleslaw, act like gonna make us jealous. Callie, I believe you should fix your face. How about that? You know what we should call this Friday? Fix Your Face Friday and dedicate it to Callie's face because it needs fixing. I've seen his mug. I've seen better. You got a mug only your mom would love.
And she's blind.
Hold that, you nipple lip looking forehead, motherfucker. Go ahead, tell us about hair.
You got a face only your mother can love. And she's blind.
Callie goes, I look beautiful in the dark.
Why? I'm that's the sexiest love, man in America in the world.
Callie, I love you like a brother, bro. Callie's so funny. Callie wakes up and starts breaking my balls. I love that shit.
Yo, I gotta get the fuck out of here.
All right, man, get out of here. Get out of here, man.
I gotta get out of here. I gotta go.
Yo, we love you. We love, you, bro. More, man. We miss Tisha, bro. We with you, bro. In the trenches, bro.
Look, I got her jewelry on today.
You got her jewelry on. Go put some of her makeup on, you know, and go to the store.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. I got a bracelet on today. You know what I'm saying? I didn't throw my hoodie on. It's raining. It's raining on us. Oh, and salute to the people. Yo, salute to the people. And please, yo, my prayers go out to people down south. Florida getting hit with this hurricane on today. That shit, I mean, well, yesterday. That shit got, that shit was bad.
They're calling it a storm.
In Georgia, South Carolina. Yo, you know what I mean? Like, yo, Vic, Bats, I hope y'all be careful out there.
Yo, why don't you go get a McDonald's and go get yourself a cheeseburger? That's what you deserve. Nice. A bacon jam burger? Yeah, toe jam. Go ahead. Yeah. All right. Yo, Mel, hello, everybody. We love you, man.
Yeah, I love you more, bro.
And we miss you, Tisha, man.
Yo, and everybody put a prayers up for Mac J,
man. Mama Adams, man.
Yo, salute for Mac J, man. Real shit.
I really do, Mel Kwan. I love you, brother, for real, man.
Yeah, I love you for real, too, Mitch.
All right. Here's my 80s choice of the week.